Friends, today the topic is electrical dipole and actually we have to find out the electrical field at the equatorial position due to the electrical dipole. So let's start without further ado. First of all, some introduction. What is called electrical dipole? Electric dipole. Okay. So it is a combination of two equal and opposite charge. Let us suppose this one is minus Q charge and this one is plus Q charge, and they are separated by a very small distance. Let us suppose the distance is 2d. Then this constitute an electrical dipole. This constitute an electric dipole, and there is a physical quantity related with it, and that physical quantity is actually known as dipole moment. It is actually known as dipole moment. So dipole moment is equal to the product of either charge, either this one or this one, whatever you take, and the separation between them. As it is a vector quantity, okay, so I should put an arrow sign. Okay, now if it is a vector quantity, it should have direction, and direction will be equal to, your direction will be along the direction from negative to positive charge. That means that the direction is indicated by the line joining from negative to positive charge. So what is the SI unit of the dipole moment? The SI unit will be equal to, for the Q charge, the unit is coulomb in SI unit, and this one is actually a distance, so it should be meter, coulomb per meter. Okay, now coming to the next topics, actually we have to find out the E at the equatorial position. Equatorial position. So let us suppose this one is dipole minus Q, and this one is the plus Q charge of the dipole, and they are separated by some distance, of course, otherwise they will not form the dipole, and the distance is 2d, and their center is O, and at this center O we draw a perpendicular. Okay, and this line is actually known as equatorial line. We have supposed that there is a point P, okay, and this point P is actually at a distance R from the center O. Now we join it here, we join it here. So of course, if this one is R and this one is 2D, then it will be equal to D, and this distance will be equal to R square plus D square. Similarly, this distance will also be equal to under root R square plus D square. So first of all, electrical field due to the negative charge at the point P, let us suppose that electrical field is denoted by the symbol E1. Now E1 will be equal to Q divided by 4 pi epsilon naught, and here actually the distance is under root R square plus D square, so we'll put over here and a square sign over here. Along the direction should be indicated. So if I put a positive unit charge, in which direction this positive unit charge will move? It will be attracted towards the negative charge, so definitely it will have a direction towards this. Let us suppose this direction is represented by a line PC. So along PC, okay. Now similarly, we will try to find out the electrical field due to the positive charge. The expression will be same. Why the expression will be same? Because this distance and this distance is same. This charge value and this charge value is same. So of course, the actually the magnitude part of E1 and E2 both are will be equal, but the direction will be different, because here if I put a positive unit charge, due to the repulsion, due to this positive charge, it will be going towards this direction. Let us suppose this one is known as PD. This is PC, this is PD. Okay. Now, this is E2 and this is E1. So, as this point is on equatorial line, so definitely this triangle will be equilateral triangle, not equilateral triangle, it will be isosceles triangle, means two sides will be equal. Okay. So, this base angle theta will be equal. Okay. And so we will resolve the electrical field into two perpendicular component. One is along the vertical component and one is along the horizontal component. So if this E1 is resolved, of course by the law of geometry, this angle will be theta. So it will be equal to E1 cos theta. And again, this next part will be E1 sin theta. It will be towards this direction, E1 sin theta. Similarly, E2, if it is resolved, it will become E2 cos theta, and again the vertical component E2 sin theta. So the sine component actually E1 sin theta and E2 sin theta, they are equal, so they cancel each other. Of course, because they are opposite in direction. Okay, so the only component that will remain, it will be the horizontal component, that is the cos theta component, and it will be equal to, simply we will write here, E is equal to E1 cos theta plus E2 cos theta. But what is E1, E2? E1 and E2 both are equal. The magnitude part of E1 is equal to magnitude part of the E2. So we will replace E1 and E2 by simply E. Okay. So it will become 2E cos theta. Let us suppose this one I am putting E dash. Okay. So E dash will be equal to 2E cos theta. Now what is E? E will be equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught. Simply under root r square plus d square, and there should be a square sign. Now what is cos theta? So here in the figure, cos theta will be equal to base by hypotenuse. Base is here d, and hypotenuse is under root r square plus d square. So we will put here base is d, and this will be equal to under root r square plus d square. Okay. Now this Q and this 2D, okay, here at the denominator part, here the part is actually, if I actually do calculation, here the power of R square plus D square will be 3/2. Why it is 3/2? Because here the power is half and here the power is actually 1. This 1/2 and this 2 will cancel, so it has a power 1 only. So 1 and this 1 has a half power, so overall it will become 3/2, that is 1.5 power. Okay, so now what is 2D? Q into 2D, it is actually the dipole moment. We already know this thing. P is equal to Q into 2D, so we can replace. So we can replace P is equal to Q into 2D. So we can replace the numerator simply by the letter P. So it will become 4 pi epsilon naught R square plus D square 3/2. Now here again, electrical field is a actually it is a vector quantity. So it is a direction. So I should put an arrow sign over here. If I am talking about the magnitude part, it is okay. But if I am talking about the direction part, I have to do it because it is a vector quantity. I have to mention it. So in which direction it will be directing? So here the direction is towards left. Okay, here the dipole moment has a direction towards right. Okay, but the overall electric field has a direction towards left. So we can replace, okay, P by simply minus P, and we will put an arrow sign over here, and now it is indicating the direction as well as magnitude part. So electrical field is directed towards the negative direction of the dipole moment direction, and the value is this one. And earlier we know very well, we calculated for the short dipole. So if the dipole is very short, so in that case D is much smaller than R. So we can just omit the value D, okay, because it is negligible. So in that case the E part, the magnitude part, will be equal to simply P 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. So this is the expression, E is equal to P by 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. But again, this is for the equatorial position, but at the axial position we learned it is equal to 2P 4 pi epsilon naught R cube. This is axial and this is equatorial. So from the above expression, if I divide it, and we will get this ratio 2 by 1. So it means that always equatorial position electrical field will have a value, okay, half of the value, okay, at the half of the value of the field at the axial position due to the dipole. Thank you.